Welcome back, everybody. Mass Effect number 1, the Legend Edition. Now, we last ended with deciding where we should go first in the galaxy. And I'm very stumped right now, so... This is the one where... Well, I've seen that maybe we should go to first. I was thinking of going Ferris first, then doing this one last. Now, the good thing is that we can explore a lot of these systems, which is actually really good, too. But yeah, this is the one where I think that the place to get that... That person, can't remember her name, but find Liara. I think she's going to be another companion in the somewhere in the Artemis Tau cluster. So I guess for now we'll do that one, because at least we can get. This is probably going to be the hardest one as well. But at least we will get our companion out of the way as well. So we are in the... Yeah, the correct system, right? Artemis Tau. So, well, it doesn't really say where to go first, so I guess we'll go to places where we can land. Let's check out these systems. So, Nusika, traces of sodium in atmosphere, new overall dark grey colour, otherwise typical hydrogen helium gas giant, abundance of water vapour, the atmosphere count as white clouds. Day length 14 Earth hours. This one, Circe. Modestly sized hydrogen helium gas giant, traces of sulfur chlorine. Day length, turn, Earth hours. I don't really get the orbital period, so... So what's... 141 Earth years, so it takes to orbit. Radius 22,000. Km, 3 mining. Proteus. This is actually a very orbital period of 4 Earth years, 10 kilometers, 10,000 kilometers radius, day length 51 Earth hours, atmospheric pressure. Colony found in 2179, capital Ithaca, population. Which I don't know why you would. There is. It's worse of Express. Sounds something like Kamino. Pharos. Distant Pharos has seen cursory examination by unnamed probe. Its trace atmosphere, nitrogen, argon, its surface composed with deposits. 275 Earth years. Surface temperature minus 76. And then there's this one, Salamis. Crust is composed of deposits, platinum, group metals. So which one can we land on? Because I've just selected them all. Can't land on any. Done Circe. I've done Nusaka. Salamis. Pharos. Is there any other planet? No. Done Proteus. Okay, well that system explored. Macedon. Shardilla. Can land there. Warning, level 1 pressure hazard. Shardilla is a very dense atmospheric and ammonia and oxygen. Its temperature surface is mainly composed by alumina deposits of sulfur. Convoys in the vessels reach a number of unregistered vessels operating nearby. Shardilla has extreme silicon-based oxygen. Heavily populated areas, recovered silica, dust from the tree. High-speed surface winds often laden the embrace silica presence hazard in the areas where the deposits of great silica footprints of treacherous EVA are discouraged. 1 Earth year, so it's the same as Earth. Day length 40 Earth hours. So does that what I mean? 1 Earth year orbital period. I don't know how that works. So 25 Celsius. We've got Shardjilla, we've got Porilin, we can survey Porilin, enormous terrestrial planet. So, half again the size of Earth. Despite the thick of atmospheric and weak output of the red dwarf, Mastodon leaves its surface biting cold, causes many composed of silica, but significant deposits of iron are distributed. As at present, these loots can make prove profitable. You will scan the planet. When the strange signal came from orbit, navigator Presley determined the signal was from the ancient beacon. Your salvage team brought the beacon aboard and found one of the matriarch Dillinger's writings in its storage compartment. Nice. Petrovic, the second of the Macedon system's giant terrestrial planets, is by far the more interesting. Most of the surface is covered by vast sea and liquid ammonia, in which unique aquatic ammonia based on has been developed, while the frozen continents are largely barren from the life. Complex systems may lie in human flesh, while dreadfully inhospitable to humans, is suitable for colonization by Volus. Negotiations between the systems lies the Volus Petrus made good progress. Ferrigluce survey. Standard hydrogen heating gas, abundance airborne hydroelica. Concentration of xenon. Well, let's just go to Shardjilla then. Don't know how we're gonna survive, but we'll see. Let's land on Shardjilla. Oh, okay. Anti-squad. We're gonna need some combat, so... I mean, I can handle the combat, though, but... Wait. What's examine squad? Oh, okay. Yeah. I think that's good. Cool, so we can choose the squad for each landing, I guess. Medal of Exploration. Land on an uncharted world. Level 1 hazard. So what are we looking for? So what do we do here? Okay, that's to shoot. What are we looking for? Oh, okay. So we're here, there's some debris over there. Oh, Caden has a lot. do something to like scan. Oh, that's. Oh, okay. Cool. They haven't really given us a great tutorial in this part of the game, lol. How do we get this debris? What do we do? Wait. Crushed probe. Yeah, cool. What do we do? What do we do? Like, nothing? How do we get out? If we can get out. Oh, I can't exit unless it's parked on middle level terrain. Oh, okay. Salvage. How do we get back in? Oh, how do we get back in? Get into vehicle. So there's a mission over there. There's a anomaly over there. Guessing the anomaly is going to be a enemy. Something over there. It's like a shelter or something. Asari capsule. Artifact recovered. It's not clear who lived here, but appears to have been abandoned for some time. The container in attendance, among other things, the Manshark Dilinga writings. Nice. Leave back. Get into the vehicle. What's over here? What is that? Therian deposit. Nice. Nice. Cover large deposit of therium. So this is how you make money. Excellent. Mission over there. It's a shame that we're in just a little borderline. I guess for Final Fantasy VII, it's a pretty big game, I guess. Ooh, enemies. Uh-oh. What did I use for? Oh, repairing.
Heading out.
Oh. The hell? Where'd you go? Upgrade kit. How do you... Thought you could hack him. Sorry, leading these slavers and Nasana dancers is important. Better the city allies, this is you should return the proceeding. Could find Nasana with this. Guess we can't. How do we return to the... Oh. Still got a quest marker. Something I did miss, or I don't think so. There's nothing else here, so if there's something else here, then enlighten me. No.
Yes, sir.
Doesn't work for those, damn it. We've got to come back to those. There we go, I think that's it. For Shardjilla anyway. Okay. Shardjilla was the only one on that system, I think, we could land on, right? Sparta. Terminair. Dwarf planet compared to one over here. Magnetic makes it possible for ships to dump drive charge in orbit. It Sterlis can land here. Grasshoppers could just be thrown inwards. The gravity is guess on. The exploration is highly dangerous. Alcides. So this is probably the one I surveyed yesterday. Is this one, Nidalians? Well, let's land. Distress signal, anomaly, and debris. What do we have behind us though? What's that? Okay. Oh, great, and that's gonna come up. God damn it. Oh. Where is it? Wait, you can't shoot while it's repairing? God damn it. Really? Far out. She just shoot it, that was coming down. Okay. Oh, goddamn. I mean, just shooting it like that is taking it out. Got it. Nice. Alliance Marine.
Alliance soldiers. Looks like they were lured here by the distress beacon.
The Citadel space is an unofficial term referring to any region of space controlled by a species that acknowledges the authority of the Citadel Council. At first glance, it appears this territory encompasses most of the galaxy. In reality, however, less than 1% of the stars have been explored. Even Mass Effect FTL Drive is slow relative to the volume of the galaxy. Empty space and systems without suitable drive discharge sites are barriers to exploration. Only the mass relays allow ships to jump hundreds of light years in an instant, the key to expanding across an otherwise impassable galaxy. Whenever a new relay is activated, the destination system is rapidly developed. From that hub, FTL Drive is used to expand to nearby star clusters. The result is a number of densely developed clusters, thinly spread across the vast expanse of space, connected by the mass relay network.
Okay, man, I've already been playing this game for almost an hour. Jesus.
The Normandy is a prototype starship developed by the Human Systems Alliance with the assistance of the Citadel Council. It is optimized for scouting and reconnaissance missions in unstable regions, using state-of-the-art stealth technology. For most ships, the heat generated through standard operations is easily detectable against the absolute zero background of space. The Normandy, however, is able to temporarily sink this heat within the hull. Combined with refrigeration of the exterior hull, the ship can travel undetected for hours or drift passively for days of covert observation. This is not without risk. The stored heat must eventually be radiated, or it will build to levels capable of cooking the crew alive. Another component of the stealth system is the Normandy's revolutionary Tantalus drive, a mass effect core twice the standard size. The Tantalus drive generates mass concentrations that the Normandy falls into, allowing it to move without the use of heat-emitting thrusters.
Right, well that's done. Today. Fights Salarian. Oh shit. Captain Millard's identification headed up here is impossible to know for sure. crashed probe salvaged. Oh, seriously? What's that? I didn't get any tech person here. God damn it. Alright, well, I'm gonna have to find that later. Jeez. Okay, well. $8. I think $1 is the only one you can land on this system. So that's two systems down. Knossos, Athens. So it's Artemis Tau system, so it has to be in the Knossos system. Phaistos. Small terrestrial planet with trace atmosphere, carbon dioxide, sand in the surface is scorching hot, making both sulfur and oxygen. There's little interest in this isolated world. World nitrogen methane atmosphere amounts. Arcanon. That's it. So it is to Theorem. Okay, so you need a tech guy. Okay.
Commander, I'm picking up some strange readings. Really strange, like off the damn charts. It looks like it's coming from an underground complex a few clicks away from the drop zone.
Damn.
cover.
Where do we go now? Thank you. Continue. Driving through Mustafar. Wonderful scene. I didn't do it. Well, okay. Oh no. That's a big one. I like that it gives us checkpoints as well. tonight. How much money do I have now? H2, same thing. Sniping in this game is... I'm not usually a sniper player, but it seems to be the easiest one so far.
Shield.
hit. Ladies and gentlemen, is why you don't go there first, because holy crap, I don't know how I'm going to do this. I came this far to do that, to get that, fucking hell. Get the oh, I need to get the sniper first, goddammit, where's that sniper? Weapons jammed. Far out. This is just too much. And that's so unfair, because here's the thing, right? You go through the whole part of that in your vehicle. Like, come on. So I don't know what the fuck to do here. It's too many things at the same time. I think you gotta take out the stalkers first. Dead. Wait, what? Seriously? Or is she just in the car? She actually dead, that's bullshit. still here. All that, and I have to do it again. I think you just get to the checkpoint, man. You take out the stalkers and you just get to the checkpoint. It's far out. Absolutely atrocious. Like, this is why it's unfair, because you go from nothing to having to deal with this. You're just so caught off guard. Like, it's so unfair. Why is my weapons jammed? Why is everything completely going wrong? How do I do so well before? Far out. you get unfair. Because you can't have your enemies come right into you like that. Like, where is the sense in taking cover? Where is the amount of time you take when you have to... I should have just stayed my fucking ground in that regular place. So much play, it's so bullshit, it's just so everything. The second time, and all of a sudden it starts to get even more impossible. I just don't understand it. You take out the stalkers first, and I don't know how the hell you're supposed to do anything else. Times I'm going to die in this section. I need to get the XP, I need to get it all, so... I ain't mad because it's just an absolute impossible section from absolute nothing. It really is, because it's come from nothing. Thank you. Well, I'm gonna be here for an hour. Bullshit rigged. I just don't know what else. Like, what am I actually doing wrong? Because there's just no way it can be this hard. You go from absolute nothing and easiness to this. Like, come on. That is 100% inconsistency. Okay, I don't know how you do this. I don't know how you do this. Just go all out combat. Because, my goodness sakes, what's the point of those other traits if they're gonna do absolutely nothing when that character is already dead? It's so bullshit. Getting harder and harder, man! What the hell? How do you go harder and harder? Why don't I just make a run for it? Yeah, screw that. Seriously. So that doesn't work either. So I have to stand my ground and take him out. Okay. Alright, well, I'll be here all night. So be it. Jam for? Are you kidding me? Why are my weapons still jammed? I knew doing this one was a bad mistake. I knew it. But I thought it was good. There was nothing wrong. Nothing was going on. Everything is going on. But this is so inconsistent because the leader is easy. There's nothing wrong at all. So that's bullshit and inconsistent game. I was so close the second time! How many times now? This might make me quit this game now. It was going perfectly fine, nothing wrong, and now just the BS has happened. And it's come with just absolute. There's nothing you can do here. There's nothing you can do. You can't sabotage me. You can't do anything. You just have to... So fast, I don't even know where it is. What the hell? This is so ridiculous. Bro, okay, well, I can't get it with this because it's too slow. Bro, look how fast it is. How can you take that out? Probably the only time that was my fault, but man, okay, so I know what to do. You gotta go to the left and you take him out from that side. It's just the smartest thing to do. How is Ashley down? Are you kidding me? I didn't know that was coming for me.
Thank you.
Wait, this is it. Oh look, and you're back alive. Yeah, screw you. You can't come back alive when we're, you know, actually in a fight, but anyway. Terrible section. Inconsistent. Thank you. USB from this.
Liara Tassoni, I presume.
Thank the goddess. I did not think anyone would come looking for me. Listen, this thing I'm in is a Prothean security device. I cannot move, so I need you to get me out of it, all right?
How'd you end up in there?
I was exploring the ruins when the Geth showed up, so I hid in here. Can you believe that? Geth, beyond the veil! I activated the tower's defenses. I knew the barrier curtains would keep them out. When I turned it on, I must have hit something I wasn't supposed to. I was trapped in here. You must get me out, please.
Your mother is working with Saren. Whose side are you on?
What? I am not on anybody's side. I may be Benezia's daughter, but I'm nothing like her. I have not spoken to her in years. Please, just get me out of here.
We'll find some way to help you.
There is a control in here that should deactivate this thing. You'll have to find some way past the barrier curtain. That's the tricky part. The defenses cannot be shut off from the outside. I don't know how you'll get in here. Be careful. There is a Krogan with the Geth. They have been trying different ways to get past the barrier.
much more. Come on. Okay.
How did you get in here? I didn't think there was any way past the barrier.
We blasted through with the mining laser.
Of course. Yes, that makes sense. Please, get me out of here before more Geth arrive. That button over there should shut down this containment field.
How we get out of this place?
There is an elevator back in the center of the tower. At least I think it's an elevator. It should take us out of here. Come on! I still cannot believe all this. Why would the Geth come after me? Do you think Benezia's involved?
Saren's looking for the conduit. Think fast, Miss Prothean expert.
The conduit? But I don't know...
What the hell was that?
These ruins are not stable. That mining laser must have triggered a seismic event. We have to hurry. The whole place is caving in.
Joker, get the Normandy airborne and lock in on my signal. On the double, mister.
Aye, aye, Commander. Secure and away. ETA 8 minutes.
He needs to move faster.
In case you didn't notice, this place is falling apart.
Exhilarating, isn't it? Thanks for getting rid of those energy fields for us. Hand the doctor over.
Whatever it is you want, you are not getting it from me.
She'll stay with us, thanks.
Not an option. Saren wants her, and he always gets what he wants. Kill him. Spare the Asari if you can. If not, doesn't matter.
Thank you.
Oh man, oh man, oh man, oh man, oh man, oh man, oh man.
Kill them. Spare the Asari.
Okay, well, great.
Spare the Asari if you can.
How do you do that? Cause you can't get away from that. How do you? Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Epic fails! Epic fails all around! Epic fails all around! Epic gaming fails all around! Not me, the game. It's the game's fault.
Spare the Asari if you can. If not, doesn't matter.
Her health must be horrible. And again, it gets harder the more you die. How is that possible?
Spare the Asari if you can. If not, doesn't matter.
How? Like, you're supposed to use your shield there, like, it doesn't really give me much help, and then I have to go back and do all the perk points again. Absolutely outrageous.
Too close, Commander. 10 more seconds, we would have been swimming in molten sulfur. The Normandy isn't equipped to land in exploding volcanoes. They tend to fry our sensors and melt our hull. Just for future reference.
We almost died out there, and your pilot is making jokes?
It's a coping mechanism. You'll get used to it.
I see. It must be a human thing. I don't have a lot of experience dealing with your species, Commander. But I am grateful to you. You saved my life back there, and not just from the volcano. Those Geth would have killed me or dragged me off to Saren.
What did Saren want with you? Do you know something about the conduit?
Only that it was somehow connected to the Prothean extinction. That is my real area of expertise. I have spent the past 50 years trying to figure out what happened to them.
How old are you exactly?
I hate to admit it, but I am only 106.
Damn! I hope I look that good when I'm your age.
A century may seem like a long time to a short-lived species like yours. But among the Asari, I am barely considered more than a child. That is why my research has not received the attention it deserves. Because of my youth, other Asari scholars tend to dismiss my theories on what happened to the Protheans.
Did your research turn up anything interesting?
What is interesting is what I did not turn up. There is remarkably little archaeological evidence of the Protheans, and even less that might explain why they disappeared. It is almost as if someone did not want the mystery solved. It is like someone came along after the Protheans were gone and cleansed the galaxy of clues. But here is the incredible part. According to my findings, the Protheans were not the first galactic civilization to mysteriously vanish. This cycle began long before them.
Where'd you come up with this theory? I thought there wasn't any evidence.
I have been working on this for 50 years. I have tracked down every scrap and shred of evidence. Eventually, subtle patterns start to emerge. Patterns that hint at the truth. It is difficult to explain to someone else. I cannot point to one specific thing to prove my case. It is more a feeling derived from a half century of dedicated research. But I know I'm right, and eventually I will be able to prove it. There were other civilizations before the Protheans. This cycle has repeated itself many times over.
What cycle? What are you talking about?
The galaxy is built on a cycle of extinction. Each time a great civilization rises up, it is suddenly and violently cast down. Only ruins survive. The Protheans rose up from a single world until their empire spanned the entire galaxy. Yet even they climbed to the top on the remains of those who came before. Their greatest achievements, the mass relays and the Citadel, are based on the technology of those who came before them. And then, like all the other forgotten civilizations throughout galactic history, the Protheans disappeared. I have dedicated my life to figuring out why.
They were wiped out by a race of sentient machines. The Reapers.
The Reapers? But I have never heard of... How do you know this? What evidence do you have?
There was a damaged Prothean beacon on Eden Prime. It burned a vision into my brain. I'm still trying to sort out what it all means.
Visions? Yes, that makes sense. The beacons were designed to transmit information directly into the mind of the user. Finding one that still works is extremely rare. No wonder the Geth attacked Eden Prime. The chance to acquire a working beacon, even a badly damaged one, is worth almost any risk. But the beacons were only programmed to interact with Prothean physiology. Whatever information you received would have been confused, unclear. I am amazed you were able to make sense of it at all. A lesser mind would have been utterly destroyed by the process. You must be remarkably strong-willed, Commander.
Okay, this isn't helping us find Saren or the conduit.
Of course, you're right. I am sorry, my scientific curiosity got the better of me. Unfortunately, I do not have any information that could help you find the conduit, or Saren.
I don't know why Saren wanted you out of the picture, but I think we'll be a lot better off if we bring you along.
Thank you, Commander. Saren might come after me again. I cannot think of anywhere safer than here on your ship. And my knowledge of the Protheans might be useful later on.
And her biotics will come in handy when the fighting starts.
Good to have you on the team, Liara.
Thank you, Commander. I am very grateful. Oh, I am afraid I am feeling a bit lightheaded.
When was the last time you ate or slept? Dr. Chakwa should take a look at you.
It is probably just mental exhaustion. coupled with the shock of discovering the Protheans' true fate. I need some time to process all this. Still, it could not hurt to be examined by a medical professional. It will give me the chance to think things over. Are we finished here, Commander?
We can talk again after you've seen the doctor. The rest of you, dismissed.
Mission reports are filed, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
We've received your report, Commander. I understand Dr. Tassoni is on the Normandy.
I assume you're taking the necessary security precautions.
Liera's on our side. The Geth were trying to kill her.
Benezia would never allow Saren to kill her daughter.
Maybe she doesn't know.
Or maybe we don't know her. We never expected she could become a traitor.
At least the mission was a success.
Apart from the utter destruction of a major Prothean ruin. Was that really necessary, Shepard?
The Geth were crawling all over those ruins. We were lucky to make it out alive.
Of course, Commander. The mission must always take priority.
Good luck, Commander. Remember, we are all counting on you.
Okay. Okay, now four. Gonna need that.
Commander, you have a minute to talk.
I keep an open door policy. If you have any concerns, lay them on me.
All right. I know things are different aboard the Normandy, but I'm concerned about the aliens, Vakarian and Rex. With all due respect, Commander, should they have full access to the ship?
Don't mince words, Chief. What's your concern?
This is the most advanced ship in the Alliance Navy. I don't think we should give them free rein to poke around the vital systems. Engines, sensors, weapons.
You don't trust the Alliance's allies?
I'm not sure I'd call the Council races allies. We, humanity, I mean, have to learn to rely on ourselves.
Standing up for ourselves doesn't mean standing alone.
I don't think we should turn down allies. I just think we shouldn't bet everything on them staying allies. As noble as the Council members seem now, if their backs are against the wall, they'll abandon us.
You've got a pessimistic view of the universe, Williams.
A pessimist is what an optimist calls a realist. Look, if you're fighting a bear and the only way for you to survive is to sick your dog on it and run, you'll do it. As much as you love your dog, it isn't human. It's not racism, not really. Members of their species will always be more important to them than humans are.
You sound like one of those Terra Firma party pamphlets, Chief.
Terra Firma is a pack of jackals. The founders had ideals. These days they just play off xenophobia and bigotry. I hope my reasons are more rational. My father, grandfather, great-grandmother, they all picked up a rifle and swore the oath of service. I guess we just tend to think of Earth's interests as our own.
It doesn't sound like you've worked with aliens before.
No, sir. Mainly I've been groundside, part of the surface garrison forces. I did get a rotation on a space station for training. Every Marine a rifleman, every rifleman ZG certified.
That's odd. Your record is spotless and your technical scores are exemplary. You should be serving with the fleet.
Anyway, that's why I haven't served with many aliens, Commander.
All right. I can see where your concerns are coming from, Williams. But this is a multilateral mission. You're going to have to work with aliens, like it or not.
It won't be a problem, Commander. You say jump, I say how high. You tell me to kiss a Turian, I'll ask which cheek.
Would you kiss anyone I ordered you to?
That depends, sir. If you ordered me to kiss a superior officer, that would be a violation of the regs concerning fraternization. That would make it an illegal order. I'd be required to decline and relieve you of command. Sir.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Not sure I buy Dr. Tassoni's story about her and her mom not talking. They're family, right?
I'm not sure I believe it either. It's better to have her where we can see her.
That makes sense. Too bad those ruins got destroyed. I mean, they lasted thousands of years. That's impressive.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Not sure I buy Dr. Tassoni's story about her and her mom not talking. They're family, right?
I'm not sure I believe it either.
That makes sense. Too bad those ruins got destroyed. I mean, they lasted thousands of years. That's impressive.
We'll talk later, Williams.
Looking forward to it, sir.
That we're gonna leave it there. It was a long and frustrating 3 hours or so, but there we go. Interesting. Alright. Well, thank you all today, and until next time, good night.